state district levels to ensure all related arrangements and preventive measures during the entire electoral process. A separate SOP is there for the COVID-19 patients, suspects quarantined for their voting. That has already been issued by the commission. Polling time has been uniformly increased. It was done in Bihar also. Again, also it's being repeated by 1 hour. And the decision is taken by the local CEO in close consultation with the DEC concerned. Several processes and procedures have been made available online in order to minimize person-to-person contact and prevent congregation of large number of people. But that doesn't mean that those people cannot exercise offline procedure for those things. The number of persons accompanying a candidate for submission of nomination has been restricted to 2. And the number of vehicles is also restricted to 2. Candidates later on can also seek electoral certification digitally besides filling the nomination form and affidavit online and the printout submitted to the RO. But as I said, these rights can be accessed offline also. Security money can also be deposited on the online board. Door-to-door campaigning has been restricted to 5 persons, including the candidate. Road shows are allowed, subject to the convoy being broken after every 5 vehicles. Ultimately, it is for the district magistrates, called collectors, called deputy commissioners, and their police counterparts, SPs, deputy commissioners, commissioners, IGs, who have to kind of finally take a view from situation to situation. But as I said, broad guidelines are there. DOs shall identify, which they have already done, the available grounds for the meetings. And CEOs have been instructed to print a list of those grounds district-wise in the English as well as vernacular papers so that people are aware which grounds are available in which state. To the best of my knowledge, the CEOs have started doing it in their respective states. Otherwise, now that the announcement is made today, they'll do it in the next 2-3 days. Adequate CAPF deployment shall be ensured during elections. All critical vulnerable polling stations have already been identified, and adequate numbers of CAPF will be deployed in such critical booths. Advanced teams are already deployed in these states and UTs. One day a news item came that some advanced teams have been sent to only to West Bengal. Then we released a press release that they were in fact sent on the very day to all the 5 states. So it was not that the teams were sent only to West Bengal. So I don't know where it came from. Any case, you are aware that to ensure optimum use of CAPF, because wherever we go, we are told that the state administration, and this is uniformly said by the local representatives, that the state police, they do their own bit and they do not let the CPF go to the critical stations, etc. So we issued a circular dated 8th February 2021, which is already in the knowledge of all of you practically, but I'll Shefali ji request her that it should also be separately loaded on the website so that everybody can see it. That circular says that now there will be a committee comprising of CEO, state police nodal officer and state CAPF coordinator to jointly work out the election security plan and ensure randomization of the security personnel. Forced deployment plans of states and UTs shall be vetted by special general and police observers. For district deployment plans, both general and police observers will approve it. This will help in optimal and far more impartial use of CPFs in area domination, especially in the vulnerable areas and communities. Besides this, all other aspects of security management, including webcasting, CCTV footage, coverage, and videography will be put in place. On 25th February 2021, Commission has directed by issuing a notification that arrangements for webcasting shall be done in all the critical polling stations and all polling stations in vulnerable areas, at least in the 50% such cases, including auxiliary polling stations, whichever is higher. I mean, if somebody can do 75, we should be too happy. If somebody can do 100, some of the CEOs did it. But 50% is the benchmark. It cannot be below 50%. You're also aware that ECI has had for some time a time-tested and robust system in deploying central observers over and above the district observers, special central observers for depending on the sensitivity of a particular state for law and order and for expenditure, etc., etc. In fact, in Bihar elections and in earlier elections also in Maharashtra,